Hi everyone, welcome to the new system design video, which is on messaging queues. And the example that we are taking is that of a standard pizza shop. So in a normal pizza shop, you must be seeing that there's somebody taking orders. And when the pizzas are being made, they don't stop taking orders. Of course, they keep taking orders from the new clients. So multiple clients request for pizzas and they get their responses immediately, like, please sit down, or can you come back after some time? So you relieve the client from expecting an immediate response by giving them a response which is not the pizza, but a confirmation that yes, the order has been placed. So what you will need then is a list which maintains order number one, order number two, and so on and so forth. Once you're maintaining this list, you note down the order, you start making pizzas. When the second client comes in, you can stop making the pizza, or if you have multiple people, somebody takes the order and just adds it to the queue of making pizzas. So if this is a queue of pizza orders, pizza order one, pizza order two, and so on and so forth, that's being mirrored by the list. And while you're working on this pizza, you can take as many orders as you like. So it's a simple architecture. And when you're done making a pizza, you remove it from this queue, which also removes it from this queue. Right, this might be the same queue itself. So once you remove it, you ask for the client to pay, and the client sends you back some money. And now they're entirely relieved. But the special thing about this was that the whole thing was asynchronous, meaning that you did not wait, you did not make the client wait for your response for payment or for the pizza. In what happened with this is that the client was able to do other tasks during that time. They might be checking out their phone, they might be going out. It doesn't really matter, but you allowed the client to be happier, to be distributing its resources elsewhere instead of just focusing on you. Similarly, this allows you, as the pizza maker, to order your tasks according to their priority. There might be one pizza which has to be made immediately. There might be something which is very easy to do, like filling up a Coke can. Maybe. So those orders can be put according to the priority. And so you are able to manipulate this queue according to the priority and allow clients to spend their time more judiciously just by using asynchronous processing. With this in mind, what could possibly happen? One really good scenario is that you become super successful and you have a chain, you have multiple outlets in your pizza shop, so something like Domino's. Let us say pizza shop 1, pizza shop 2, and pizza shop 3. And of course, each pizza shop has multiple clients connected to them. Assume the worst. Assume that one of these shops actually goes down. There's a power outage. Could be anything. If it does go down, then we need to get rid of all our takeaway orders. So that's easy. We just need to dump them. But the delivery orders can actually be sent to the other shops. So they can complete those delivery orders and you can still save some money. In which case, let's say pizza shop 3 goes down. If it does, then the clients which are connected to it had some orders. Now they should be connected to these shops. And their orders should be sent to them. How do you do this? Well, the simple way of maintaining a list in memory won't work, because once the shop is down, it loses electricity, the computer is going to shut down. You need some sort of persistence in your data, which means you need a database. And this list has to be stored in that database. So in our new and slightly complicated architecture, what we are going to have is a set of servers from S0 to S3, so we have 4. And we also have a database which is going to be storing the list of all orders that you have. So the order IDs, the contents, and is it done or not. Now let us say that the servers get orders. So this is containing order number 3, order number 8, order number 20, and order number 9. Now, let's put some more over here, which is order number 11. So 9 and 11 are being served by S3, and S3 crashes. If that's the case, 9 and 11 need to be rerouted somewhere. But how do you do this? One way is to check in the database which orders belong to S3. So you can note down the server ID, which is actually handling the order every time it's making an entry. But this is getting complicated. So instead, what you could do is have some sort of a notifier. So that'll be somewhere over here, which is going to be checking for a heartbeat in each server. So it talks to each server and asks them if they're alive every 10 seconds, every 15 seconds. What happens with that is if a server does not respond, then the notifier assumes that that server is dead. If it is dead, it can't handle orders, and then it can query the database to find all of those orders which are not done. Once they're not done, it picks those orders and distributes them to these three servers, remaining servers. Problem. What if there is duplication? What if order number three is not yet done and it's picked by the query in the database? So 3, 8, 20, 9, and 11 are picked up and then distributed. So order number three, let's say this time, goes to server number one. Server number two already had order number three and is processing it and is going to end up making a pizza, sending it to the same place as S1 is, and you have a big loss and lots of confusion. So one of the things you can do is go for some sort of load balancing. Now, load balancing seems like sending the right amount of load to each server, but the principles of load balancing ensure that you do not have duplicate requests to the same server. If you haven't checked out the video for load balancing, I suggest you do, because consistent hashing is one technique by which you can actually get rid of duplicates also. So that principle itself will take care of two things. One is balancing the load, and the second one is not sending duplicates to the same server. Reason for that is because S1 is going to be handling a set of buckets, S2 is going to be handling a set of buckets. Once this server crashes, S2 won't lose its buckets. It'll only get new buckets added to it. S1 will also get new buckets added to it. And therefore, the third order will never come because they belong to S2 even now. And maybe the other orders of 9 might come in and 11 might come in here. So that's how it works. Okay. Through load balancing and through some sort of a heartbeat mechanism, you can notify all the failed orders to the newer servers. Now, what if you want all the features of assignment or notification, load balancing, a heartbeat, and persistence in one thing? That would be a message queue. And for us, it's not so much a message as a task queue, right? So what this does is it takes tasks, persists them, assigns them to the correct server, waits for them to complete. If it's taking too long for the server to give an acknowledgement, it feels that the server is dead and then assigns it to the next server. So there are multiple strategies, of course, for assigning it. So that is just like load balancing has multiple strategies, but that's all encapsulated by a task queue. And this is an important concept in system design, using messaging queues or task queues to get work done easily, so that you can encapsulate all that complexity into just one thing. The pizza example is a little extreme because it does everything together. So that's exactly what a pizza shop would want, a task queue, right? And an example of messaging queues is RabbitMQ. There are some libraries like 0MQ, which allow you to write a messaging queue quite easily. There's JMS, which is Java Messaging Service, and then so on and so forth. I think Amazon also has a few messaging queues, but yeah, you can try out messaging queues. They are really good encapsulations for complexities in the server side. This is just a fundamental concept of system design, not really a system which has been designed. But yes, if you're going to make a pizza shop, it seems like a good idea. If you want to have some more discussion on this, let's have a discussion in the comments below. And if you like the video, press the like button. If you want to subscribe for further system design notifications, please do so, and I'll see you next time. And saying that, I'm done. Asynchronous processing means that